I had no idea at the time that this pin was worth $200.
I ain't feeling lonely, in a corner, man, it's time to end the ride. Fading it too slowly, were those gonna lift me up this time? You were the only one who got me tripping up inside. All the words you told me, am I reading something different from your eyes? See you, for a moment even hope that I could feel you. See you, over the road.
What's up YouTube? I hope all you guys are having an awesome, fantastic day. Today we're going to be doing some more Disney pin trading around Walt Disney World. Now, a few days ago, I uploaded a video and it magically got deleted from YouTube. YouTube is broken for whatever reason. YouTube just can't get their act together. So it just disappeared, got deleted off my channel. I don't know why. So we'll be filming a lot new clips today for today's video, but don't be kind of tempted away if you guys see a few clips from that video from a few days ago. I think only like 800 of you guys saw it. It got deleted within like an hour and a half, 2 hours. So I'm gonna throw some of those clips in today's video. But pretty much today, we're gonna start at one of those side Disney gift shops and see if they have any good deals on pins. And then we're gonna make our way over to the value resort. So All-Star Music, All-Star Sports, Movies, Pop Century, Art of Animation, and maybe end back up at the Magic Kingdom. To just do some pin trades and see what we can get into. Now, it is the week of 4th of July, so I'm really not going to do many videos this week just because I have so much going on. The cruises in a few days. I'm going to be filming July 3rd, and that video will be up July 4th for you guys. But this may be the only regular video this week, so we'll make it a good one. Hopefully, you guys are ready because I am. Let's go do this.
We stopped here just to see if they have any kind of Disney pins and, you know, how cheap or less expensive they would be. So let's go in here and check it out. This is located right next to the Chick-fil-A, and CP housing is right over there, and then Disney Springs is just right down this road here. And here's a look at what pins they have in here, and they all are legit. I mean, I just bought this one and I checked the backs and they're real. Here's the prices, 4 for $20. But then look at these. They have these value packs for $20 and you get 10 of them. Got me the goofy one, but wow, just come in here, buy you a pack of these and you're ready to trade. They have all kinds of good ones here.
Yeah.
And they have like older ones too, like this Mickey Monorail one I just picked up.
Well, look at this, the gondolas are running. I really love this resort, Art of Animation. So we're starting off the vlog here because we usually have really good luck with trading pins here in the gift shop.
Always ask a cast member to see the pin board. I like these. Looks like Dan's bringing out his big guns. He's gonna make a trade.
Ooh, this pin is pretty awesome. The whole reason I decided I wanted to come back over here to Art of Animation was because I wanted the pin over here, but I just talked to a manager because they've been sold out for weeks, ever since I saw it about 2 weeks ago. They've been sold out and they are getting a new redesign of the Art of Animation pin because they're so popular, and they're not gonna be back in stock until August. The way pin trading works at Walt Disney World is you can trade with any cast member, but you can only trade up to 2 pins, not 3, not 4, only 2. But you can trade with like other people and other visitors around Walt Disney World that are not cast members, and you can trade how many ever you want, but just with cast members, you can only trade up to 2. If you guys are looking to start your own pin trading set, I would do one of these starter sets. It comes with a lanyard and 4 pins. And you can start trading.
Ooh, I kind of like this one. And you always want to check the backs of them after you trade. This one is from Shanghai. And this is how you can tell if it's real, what year it is. I think I scored on this one.
Okay, I'm going to interrupt really quick because I had no idea at the time that this pin was worth $200. $199 on eBay. I only have one of them, so I can't imagine just what the one is worth. But imagine if I had all three. That's $200 in my pocket. And this was just on a cast member's lanyard in the gift shop in Art of Animation. This cast member had no idea. Literally money on her necklace. I can't believe that. This is cool. I'm not trading this pin. And it's from Shanghai. Okay, we can go back now. Next up, Caribbean Beach. I haven't been here a good long time. It's good to be back. I do enjoy this resort.
Ooh, I like this one. That was the Genie, Tigger. is that one? And then look at this, it's like a sword. Pin board.
And we have a pin chest in the back.
Oh, is it in the back?
The
all right.
Chest is in the back.
Well, we want to go to the pin chest. That sounds fun. And I just traded for these two. So really nice. Heck yes. Oh man, it's an actual treasure chest. I like it. That's awesome. I really want this Walt Disney World luggage case from my Tokyo trip. It's $200. I do get that AP discount for 20%. I think I'm gonna pull the trigger in the next couple weeks just because I'm sick of my luggage getting picked up by people at the airport. So I think that would stand out and I'll just put PCD on it or something like that. Would love to just jump in this pool right now. The temperature just crossed 100 degrees right now. Look, the gondolas. Look at the update construction for the new Disney's Riviera Resort. That's gonna be opening really, really soon. Looks pretty much almost done. Still have a few things to do on the outside right there as they're going to work right now. And then it's where the gondola station is gonna be, the Disney Skyliner. They're not running right now. But they go all through Caribbean Beach. Next up, we're here at Disney's All-Star Movies, which is a fun resort. It's a good value. Let's go in here, see what we can find. There's a huge cheerleader squad incoming tour group. Oh man, we're talking old school here. I remember these. Look at Joe coming in clutch. You wanna be in the vlog?
Huh?
You wanna be in the vlog? This is Joe. What's up, man? Got some good ones. I like how it's shaped. Oh, happy trading. Joe was real nice with the pin trading, but for some reason we asked a few cast members walking in if we could see their pins and they were pretty rude to us. This is the ghetto Disney resort. I mean, it's still a nice resort, but it's the ghetto version of a Disney resort. Holy cow. Look at the cupcakes. There's a Pixar one. Peaches and cream. This one looks good. They have cannolis. They have edible cookie dough. Oh my goodness. They have one in the food court. I think Dan's gonna get this one. They have the Hercules one. I just got that. Marathon 2019. I may have to get that one.
Oh, you put out a big one too.
Huh. Just traded for this one, the 2019 Walt Disney World Marathon. I didn't run it, but I was here. This is a pretty good one. But we did get the edible cookie dough. It was only $3.85, so let's give it a try. I would say 9 out of 10. It was really good. It was cheap. It was refreshing. I mean, me and Dan had to share it because this is just way too much sugar, but yeah, it's good. I think this is the only place you can get it too. Oh, I love minivans.
Me too.
It's the best service. Yeah. And we just got dropped off, and look where we are. Right at the front gates of Magic Kingdom. I tell you what, that's worth the $30 or some change, yeah. Today's dining review is coming from Tony's Town Square Restaurant, where it's themed Lady and the Tramp. Oh man, look at this one. It's a passport to Magic Kingdom. And it opens. How neat. I bought the passport one. It was too good not to buy. We got sat outside in the little, what is this, like a greenhouse type thing? Still pretty nice out here. The sun's not really bothering us at all. AC's blasting. And thanks to my mama bear back home, I now have reusable straws to use in the parks. Well, ain't this the cutest menu around town? Let's see what they have inside. Of course, you have a whole lot of wine. For appetizers, ooh, garlic parmesan wings, spaghetti, Tony's pizza pie, chicken fettuccine. I think I'm definitely gonna go with the chicken parmesan. Oh wow, now that looks delicious. Let's dig in. You know, I really enjoyed lunch at Tony's. I heard a lot of negative things about Tony's and that's why I was always so hesitant to coming here. Food was great, about an 8 out of 10. I have no complaints. I mean, it wasn't the best chicken parmesan I've ever had. I like Olive Garden's chicken parm, but it was good. Really good. I enjoyed it. You enjoy it too?
Oh, it was great. Yeah. Again, it wasn't like the best chicken parmesan ever. Hey, we're vlogging here. But it was good.
Would you come back?
Oh yeah.
I'll come back too.
Pizza, yeah. The pizza looked good.
The pizza did look good.
And look at this. If you guys follow along with the Character Warehouse videos, this was $3.99 and it's still $9.99 here in the park. Here's a look at the update construction work going from Fantasyland into Liberty Square on this bridge. What they're doing, they're only expanding the walkway because it used to be a very little walkway and used to get very congested, but they are expanding it. And then once that's done, they will put the water back in here. But they're pretty much almost done. I mean, you can see how big the walkway is now. Well, we have a fast pass to ride Haunted Mansion, but look at the fast pass line. This has been happening constantly. Not really sure what the issue is. Let's go in the gift shop and maybe that'll kill some time. I'm in the Haunted Mansion gift shop and I found some good ones. Oh my goodness. Look at this one. And the Stitch. Look at these. Wow. Hey Abby, look who I ran into. Mickey in the Haunted Mansion.
I'm here with Julian from Katy, Texas.
Howdy y'all.
It's the best you got. Her name's not Julian. She's not from Katy, Texas.
I'm actually from Houston, Texas, so I hope all y'all have a great day today. Hanging out with Dev over here at the Magic Kingdom.
That was good.
If any of y'all have any questions for me, feel free to stop on by.
You know what? I'm feeling some filler magic today.
I want more.
Look at this Dumbo phone case. Now that's a little too much. That can't even fit in your pocket. Look at these. Just got me this one. Pete as a pirate. Holy cow. Look at Tron. It is massive and it's not even 20% done. I like how Disney finally figured out that people love backpacks. It's Enchanted Tiki Room. Haunted Mansion. Mickey. And then the Disney snacks. How much are these? I'm curious. $29.99, so not too horrible. Lisa Simpson? Are you lost? What we're doing now is something that Magic Kingdom will do a couple times a day. It is now 4 o'clock, and this is where all the pin collectors will come, and you'll actually be able to trade with Disney fans, and you'll also be trading with cast members, and they'll bring out a lot of exclusive rare pins that you can trade for. This is really fun. You get to pick a number and you have the option to trade for two pins if you do want to trade. You don't have to trade. So let's give it a shot. Let's try number two. That's my favorite number.
Number two. Alright, so you got two choices, sir. You can trade one or zero.
Ooh. I think I'm gonna hold on to mine, but those are some good ones. I mean, look at all these pins. They're everywhere. Holy cow, look at all these pins. This is William. He's been watching since my college program. Holy cow, look at your shirt, man. I approve. We're now in the Pirates of the Caribbean gift shop. And look at this. It's like in a treasure chest. I'm finally going to do this magic shot here at Magic Kingdom. Is you stand right here, and there's cameras on top of that Plaza restaurant building right here. And it'll zoom in, take a picture, and then it will zoom out, and you get to see the whole castle hub in the background. I've waited for you. Now I have a question.
All right.
This is my fourth time coming here to see you.
Yeah. Well, love me, don't you?
A little bit.
Just can't get enough, can you?
Are you ready for a prince? I ask you every time. Why are you not ready for a prince?
I don't need anyone by my side to rule my kingdom.
What about another huntsman? Because the other one, because he didn't get the job done last time.
I have tons of dirty work.
Okay, so I can help you out on that.
No eyes,
but then when you are ready for a prince, I'm here. Maybe. That's better than your answer last time. You actually had to think about it.
And I'll never question it.
All right, you got a deal.
We just finished up dinner at Storybook Dining over at the Wilderness Lodge. That's what that last clip was from. I didn't film anything because I love this place and I just kind of want to enjoy it. But I love my interactions with the Evil Queen. It's always the best. And one day, I will become her prince. But what a fun day pin trading around Walt Disney World. Holy cow. I'll tell you guys one thing. The Disney resorts, those are the jackpots. Oh, for the pins, there's so many good rare pins and cast member only pins. Magic Kingdom was fun too, And that event happens every single day. A couple times during the day, I went to the 4 o'clock one. They spread out like Frontierland, Main Street. The one we went to was at Filler Magic in Fantasyland, where all the cast members and pin collectors, you know, got together. That was fun. That happens every single day, only at Magic Kingdom. I know Epcot does one on the weekends with like just pin collectors, but no cast members. So let me know down in the comments if you guys are in the pin trader like I am, because it's really becoming a really nice habit, and it's addicting, and it's a, you know, I enjoy it very, very much. And then going to the that off Disney location gift shop right by the Chick-fil-A heading to Disney Springs. It's like 11 minutes away from Disney Springs, not even that. 10 pins for $19.99. Wow. And they got like old school pins, and it was so cheap, 4 for $20. I highly recommend you guys make a trip out to this gift shop, or pretty much any of those gift shops, to get you some pins just to start. Wow. I think I kept some and then I traded some, and just, you know, because you got to have pins in order to trade them. So that was really cool doing that, and now I know where to go to buy more pins. But I'm gonna let you guys go. I hope you guys have an amazing 4th of July. Remember, I'm not going to be as active this week just because I have so much to do, and the, you know, getting ready for the cruise next week. Tomorrow I'm doing a DVC tour. Hopefully I'm able to film that, because me and Dan are looking into buying DVC finally. So we're going to do that tour tomorrow. Maybe I can bring you guys along, maybe not. And then 4th of July, I'll have a video up for you guys, since I'm going into Magic Kingdom on the 3rd and filming all that. Then I'll be in Epcot in the morning of the 4th just to meet all the characters in their outfits. And then that video will be up, and then we're off to the cruise. And yeah, that's all I got for you guys today. I love you guys so very much, and thank you guys for all the love and support from my last video. I know me and Bianca really appreciate it, and it does make my heart smile a lot. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Smash it, bop it, we can get those likes all the way up. If you guys enjoyed it and you guys care, subscribe if you guys are new here. We do this quite often. Leave a comment down below and let me know if you guys are addicted to these pins, and what do you guys thought of today's video? I'm curious. It is nice to be nice. And YouTube, see you guys in the next video. Prince Charming.